Hi kids, now we are going to learn about the rural life and society. In this one, first you are going to learn about the land revenue policy under the British rule. What are the land revenue policy? It was introduced in the British rule alone. The types of land revenue policy under British rule are permanent settlement, Ryotwari system and Mahalwari system. Permanent settlement, it was introduced by Lord Cornwallis. Ryotwari system by Thomas Munro. Mahalwari system by Lord William Bentinck. In this one, first we will enter into the permanent settlement. Permanent settlement, actually it was introduced by Cornwallis, I told. Before that, Robert Clive, he introduced the annual settlement of land revenue. After that, Warren Hastings, he introduced the quinquennial. Quinquennial means five yearly settlement, annual settlement he introduced. After that alone, the Cornwallis, he introduced the permanent settlement for the 10 years. The settlement for the 10 years in 1793 introduced. Actually, he made this settlement in Bengal, Bihar, Orissa, Varanasi and UP. Okay, and as well as in the northern Karnataka also. Most probably 19% of the total area of the British India, we may say. It was known by the different name: Zamindari, Zagirdari, Molguzari and Biswedari. First of all, we will move on to the silent features of the permanent settlement. What are the silent features? The Zamindars were recognized as the owners of land as long as they paid the revenue to the East India Company regularly. The Zamindars, they paid the taxes to the East India Company. That means what are the revenue they are collecting from the peasants, what they will do, they will pay to the East India Company. So they are recognized as the owner of the land. The Zamindars are recognized as the owner of the land because they collected the revenue from the peasants, and what they did, they paid to the East India Company. The Zamindars acted as the agent of the government for the collection of revenue from the cultivators. They are only the middlemen. What they did, they collected the revenue from the cultivators, that means the peasants, and they paid to the government. The amount of revenue that the Zamindars had to pay to the company was firmly, it was fixed and would not be raised under any circumstances. That means what they did there, through the permanent settlement, the amount that should be paid by the Zamindars, it is only the fixed amount. If they are cultivating more also, that means the peasants, if they are cultivating more, means the Zamindars, they will collect the money from them, but they won't pay that one to the government. That means who are enjoying here? Zamindars alone enjoying. One person is cultivating the land and he giving the production there, and through that production only is getting some amount, isn't it? That one, it was collected by Zamindars, who is not at all doing any work. That Zamindar also is not paying full amount to the government. What they are doing there? Just the government already, they fixed some amount there. If there is a famine, otherwise there is a flood, if they are giving the more production, that is none of their business. Okay, if there is a famine or flood, otherwise they are giving the more production also, definitely they should pay some amount. That one, it was fixed. They gave 10 by 11 of the revenue collected by them from the cultivator to the government. 10 by 11, that means 1% they are collecting, like that only it's given there. But it is not real thing. They are not taken only the 1%. Okay. They took most of the revenue of the cultivators and only little bit only they paid to the government. The Zamindars would grant patta to the ryots. The ryots became tenants since they were considered the tillers of the soil. Ryots means here peasants, cultivators. Cultivators only we are calling as a ryots. Okay. That Zamindars would grant patta to the ryots. They should give some patta. Patta means written agreements. Okay. That written agreements to the ryots who were the real tiller of the soil. Tiller means, I think so, you know, isn't it? Those who are tilling the soil, that person only we are saying as a, that means who is cultivating the crops. The person who is cultivating the crops only we are saying as a tiller of the soil. All judicial powers were taken away from the Jamindas. Jamindas, they had some judicial power, but that and all, it was taken away by the permanent settlement. What are the merits of this settlement? Under this system, many of the wastelands and forests become cultivable lands. The Jamindas became the owner of the land. The Jamindas were made free from the responsibility of providing justice. The Jamindas remained faithful to the British government. Everything is what where they are saying only about the Jamindas. That means who are the enjoyable person here? Only the Jamindas only enjoyed there. Okay. This system secured a fixed and stable income for the British government. British government also received the stable income. Stable income means permanent income, we may say. Okay, permanent income. They received, British government, they received. What are the demerits? Merits means advantages, demerits means disadvantages. The British government had no direct contact with the cultivators. They are not directly had the contact with the cultivators. The right of the cultivators, it was ignored by the Jamindars. Okay, the peasants were almost treated as a serfs. Serfs means we may say as a slaves. The peasants, they were treated as a slaves alone. This system was made the Jamindas lethargic and luxurious. Through this system, what there happened? Only the Jamindas, they led the luxurious life there. Many conflicts between the Jamindas as well as the peasants arose in rural Bengal.